Dear students, open all of your 10th class textbooks and keep in front of you. Today, I am going to start a new chapter, Sets. This is the second chapter of your 10th class maths textbook. And it is very easy to score the marks in the public examinations. Come to the word, the definition of, let us firstly define what is meant by set. A set is a collection of well-defined objects. Okay, now what is meant by well-defined objects? Firstly, what is meant by object? Here, object means any living being or non-living beings. For example, a collection of boys in your class, collection of girls in your class, collection of plants and trees in your school, collection of your family members, like that. Object may be a living being or a non-living being. And come to the word well-definedness. What is meant by well-definedness? For example, let us see. It should be possible to say any object in this universe is in this collection or not, but not both. Once again, see, what is meant by well-definedness? It should be possible to say whether any object in the universe is in this collection or in this collection or not. But not both. For example, let us I will give example for what is meant by well-defined and what is meant by not well-defined. Consider all tall boys in your class. Consider a collection of all tall boys in your class. See, for example, the Rohit. Whether Rohit belongs to this collection or not. Can anyone say? Once again, I am saying the collection of tall boys in your class. Say, the Rohit. Whether the Rohit is in this collection or not. Just think and tell. Now, I feel it is not possible to say whether he is in this collection or not. Because, how you are defining tallness in your class? How you define tallness in your class? It is meaningless, tallness means. For example, the average Indian, the average height of Indian students is 5.6. For you, if you go for South Africa, the average height of the students will be 6 feet. Therefore, here it is not possible to say whether the Rohit is in this collection or not. Now, for example, if I change a small thing in this, all the tall boys of your class whose height is more than 5.6 feet. Once again, I am changing a little bit. All tall boys of your class whose height is 5.6 feet. For example, I will take a tape and I will measure the height of Rohit. If he is 5.6 or more, he will be in this collection. If he is less than 5.6, he is not in this collection. Okay, therefore, if you specify the height of the person, then the collection will be well defined. And I will give one more example. All good cricketers of India, whether this collection is well defined or not. Once again, I'm telling the collection of all good cricketers of India. I'm asking you whether this collection is well defined or not. See here, someone will like a defensive play like EVS Lakshman, which he is not liked by all the Indians. Someone will like Tendulkar and Sehwag, like that. Therefore, it is not possible to say a specific cricketer, say Sachin Tendulkar, is in this collection or not. Okay, well-defined means what here? It should be possible to say whether any object in the universe is in this collection or not. Then we say that collection is well-defined. Okay, what is meant by set? Set is a collection of well-defined objects. Okay. Now, consider, already you know, we say the set of natural numbers. See, generally, the sets are denoted by uppercase letters. Okay. The sets are denoted by uppercase letters. Like capital A, capital B, capital C, and so on. And, you know, what is meant by natural numbers? We say in 9th class, 8th class also, the set of natural numbers. At the, in 9th class or in below 9th class, you don't know the exact definition of set. Now here, set of natural numbers. Here natural number starts with N. Generally we denote the set of natural numbers by capital N. Capital N. Okay. Now the objects in the set are called elements. The objects in the set are called what here? Elements. Here, consider the set of natural numbers. And the elements of the set are enclosed with the flower brackets. Okay. What are the elements? The objects in the set are called elements. Okay. The elements of the set are enclosed in flower brackets. That means like this. These are called flower brackets. And the elements in the set are separated by comma. Comma. Okay, once again see, what are meant by elements? The objects in the set are called elements. The objects in the set are called elements. Okay, and how the elements are enclosed? The elements are enclosed by flower brackets. The elements are enclosed by flower brackets. How the elements are separated? The elements are separated by commas in between them. Commas in between them. Once again, I am reminding. What is meant by elements? The objects of the set are called elements. The objects of the set are called elements. And how the elements are enclosed? The elements are enclosed by the flower brackets. The flower brackets means like this. These are called flower brackets. Starting and ending. Starting and ending. Now, how the elements of the set are separated? The elements of the set are separated by commas. Okay. All of you know that. What are natural numbers? 1, 2, 3, so on. Now, I will start the flower bracket. And this is. What is the first element of the natural number? That is 1. And next is 2. What I said? The elements are separated by commas. Therefore, I will write 1 comma, 2 comma, 3 comma, 4 comma, so on. This is closing flower bracket. This is closing flower bracket. Now, the natural number starts with what here? English alphabet, N. Generally, we denote the natural numbers by capital N. And what is the next set of natural numbers? Generally, whole numbers. Whole number starts with what here? W. We denote the set of, how the sets are denoted? Generally, the sets are denoted by uppercase letters. Uppercase letters. Okay. Now, the whole numbers are denoted by W. That is W. Okay. Now, what is the first whole number? 0. And next is 1. Now, how the elements are separated here? The elements are separated by commas in the sets. That means 0, 1, 2, 3, so on. Next, what are the integers? The set of integers, the set of integers are denoted by, the integer starts with the English alphabet I. Generally, we denote the set of integers by capital I, Z also, capital Z. This includes what? Now, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, so on, and the negative integers, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, so on. This is the set of whole numbers. Okay. Now, for example, consider. Now, this symbol denotes belong to. This symbol denotes what here? This symbol read as belong to. Belong to. Now, consider the set of natural numbers. Whether 0 is an element of natural numbers. Friends, hear carefully. Now, this is read as what here? You like that this is like E, but not this E. You simply write C and insert a horizontal line. This we read this as belong to. Now consider this set of natural numbers. Here, whether 1 is an element of natural number, that means whether 1 is in the set of natural numbers, see and tell me. Yes, 1 is an element of natural number. Therefore, here we write 1 belong to N. 1 belong to N. Similarly, 2 is an element of natural number. Yes, 2 is in the set of natural number. Therefore, we write 2 belong to N. And I am asking one more question for you. Whether 0 is an element of natural number? That is 0 one. If 0 is in the set of natural numbers, what is your answer? 0 is not in the set of natural numbers. You can clearly tell, see and tell me. Yes? Whether 0 is included in the set of natural numbers? No, 0 is not included in the set of natural numbers. Therefore, here we write 0 and this is belong to, and write a vertical line on belong to. This stands for what here? If this is there, we read this as belong to. And if you write one vertical line on this, we read this as does not belong to. Does not belong to. Okay, what is the does not? Does not belong to. Okay, now just what I will. Okay, what this symbol stands for? See, like first I write C and write one horizontal line. This symbol denotes what here? Belong to. Okay, belong to. Belong to. And what this symbol stands for? You write belong to and write a vertical line on it. And this should be read as does not belong to. Does not belong to. What is the set of natural numbers? Set of natural numbers is denoted by capital N, and what are the elements of natural numbers? 1 comma, 2 comma, 3 comma, 4 comma, so on. Okay. Now here, 1 is an element of natural number. Yes, it is an element of natural number. We write this as what here? Belong to N. Now whether 5 is an element of natural number? Of course, here 5 is not there, but we have to write 5 also. Because it will go like that, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are infinite natural numbers are there. It is not possible to write all natural numbers. That's why we write to some extent 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Later on we'll put dot, 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 dot. It indicates there are so many natural numbers. Okay. Now whether 5 is an element of natural number? Yes. Therefore we write 5 belong to natural numbers. And what about 0? Whether 0 is an element of natural number? See and tell me. That means 0 is here, 0 is not included in the set of natural numbers. Therefore, how to write? What this stands for what here? Belong to. This stands for what here? Belong to. How to write does not belong to? See, write belong to and I write vertical line on it. That means here, I write this as 0 does not belong to set of natural numbers. Okay. And come to the, whether minus 1 is an element of natural number? Minus 1. No, here the natural numbers does not contain negative numbers. That means here minus 1 is not element is not an element of natural number. That means I will write here minus 1 does not belong to N. Okay? And once again, I will remind you what the definitions went on today's class. What are elements? What are elements? The objects in the set are called what here? Elements. What are elements? The objects of the set are called elements. How the elements are enclosed? The elements are enclosed with flower brackets. The elements of the set are enclosed with flower brackets. How the flower brackets? This is starting flower bracket and this is ending flower bracket. Now how the elements in the set are separated? The elements in the set are separated by commas, like this, 1, comma, 2, comma, 3, comma, 4, comma, 5. And what is the symbol of belong to? Belong to means right? Write C and insert a horizontal line in between these two. This is called belong symbol, belong to. And what is does not belong to? Write the symbol belong to and write a vertical line on it. This symbol stands for does not belong to. Okay. All of you, open your textbooks and keep in front of you page number 33. पेज नंबर 33 एंड द लेट अस गो थ्रू द एक्सरसाइज सेट 2.1 ओके विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग आर सेट्स जस्टिफाई युअर आंसर 2.1 एक्सरसाइज पेज नंबर 33 विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग आर सेट्स जस्टिफाई युअर आंसर Now, the first collection is given. The first problem, come to this. Now, the collection of all the months of a year beginning with the letter J. Okay. Now, first, what is the first question? The collection of all the months of a year beginning with the letter J. Okay. Generally, how many months are there in a year? There are 12 months. Among these 12 months, what are the months which starts with the Which starts with the letter J. Now, January. January, February, no, March, no, April, no, May, no. What about June? June starts with J. July starts with J. August, September, October, November, December. Therefore, this collection contains only 3 months. That means the months of a year which starts with J are namely 3. Those are Jan, June, July. Where this collection is well defined? Yes, this collection is well defined. Whoever write this collection, the students will get the same collection. Okay, therefore this collection is a set because this collection is well defined. When come to the second question, the collection of 10 most talented writers in India. Talented writers in India. What is meant by talented writers? For example, some will like comic books, some will like action books. Okay, it is not possible to say which book is in this collection, so which writer is in this collection and not. Therefore, the second question, this collection is not well defined, therefore it is not a set. Okay, now a team of 11 best cricket batsmen in the world. A team of 11 best cricket batsmen in the world. Here also, this collection is not well defined because best cricketer means someone like Tendulkar, someone like Sehwag, someone like V.V.S. Lakshman and someone like Smith. Therefore, it is not possible to say who is the best cricketer for all. Okay, therefore this collection is also not a set. The collection of all boys senior class. Come to the fourth question. Collection of all boys senior class. Is it possible to say who is a boy and who is a girl? Yes, of course. Therefore, the collection of all boys in your class is well defined. Just starting from like you write all the names of boys of your class, and this will be a well defined. This collection is well defined. Therefore, this is a set. And the collection of all even integers. Okay. Now, the collection of all even integers means what is meant by an even integer? What is meant by an even integer? If you divide by 2, the remainder should be a 0. Then such numbers are called what here? Even integer. An integer is said to be even number. An integer is said to be even number if it is divided by 2. Okay, once again, what is meant by even integer? An integer is said to be even integer if it is divided by 2. For consider 4. Now, whether it is even integer? Yes, 2 2 4. That means 4 is divided by 2. Therefore, it is an even integer. Now, what about 0? 0 is even integer or not? What is your answer? Now, 0 is an even integer. Because, now, 2, 0 ja 0. Therefore, the remainder is 0. 0 is also what here? An even integer. Now, even integer starts with 0, 2, 4, 6, so on. And negative even integers are -2, -4 and so on. I hope you understood this first question. Okay, right. And come to the second question. In the second question, 3 sets are given. Namely, that is set capital A, that is A is equal to 0, 2, 4, 6. And here the set B is given as 3, 5, 7. And what are these called? Flower brackets. What are these called? Elements. Elements are separated by commas in between them. Okay. and the third set is given as C. That is C is equal to what is the P comma Q comma R. P comma Q comma R. Now, what is the question? Find the appropriate symbol that is read as what here? This is read as belong to. This is read as belong to, and this is read as does not belong to. Okay. This is read as what here? Belong to, and this is read as what here? Does not belong to. Okay. Now, what is the question? Fill the appropriate symbol belong to or does not belong to in the blanks. Now, first is what here? 0, and the next is given. Whether 0 is an element of A, that means where 0 is there in the set A, yes. Therefore, the symbol will be 0 belong to A. And come to the second question. 3, fill in the blank, that is C. The 3 is in the set C, observe and tell. Whether 3 is an element of the set C? No. See, because C is not there in the element. See, this is not this C. Elements. Okay, here 3 does not belong to C. Come to the third one. 4 B. Now, this is the fill in the blank. We have to fill it. 4. 4 is an element of B. No, here 4 is not there in the set B. Therefore, I will write the symbol 4 does not belong to B. And come to the fourth question. And 8, where 8 is in the set A? No. Therefore, 8 does not belong to A. Come to the fifth question. What is the fifth question? P and the set C. Whether P is in the set C? Yes. That means here we write P belong to C. And come to the sixth question. 7 and B. Whether 7 is an element of B? Yes, 7 is an element of B. That is 7 belong to B. These are the. So this is the second question. I hope you understood. Yes, I am erasing this. Come to the third question. Express the following statements using symbols. As far as this exercise is concerned, we are using only two symbols. That is, number one, the symbol is this belong to. Belong to, and this is does not belong to. Does not belong to. Okay, now the element X does not belong to A. First question, third question. First question, the element X does not belong to A. How to write X? This is belong to. But he said does not belong to. Therefore, X does not belong to A. This is third first question. And come to the third second question. D is an element of set B. D is an element of set B. D belongs to B. D is an element of B. How to write? D belong to set B. Okay. And 1 belong to the set of natural numbers. How the set of natural numbers are denoted by? Set of natural numbers are denoted by capital N. One is the set of natural number. 1 belong to N. And come to the fourth question. S does not belong to, 8 does not belong to the set of prime numbers P. Now, does not belong to set of prime numbers P. See, this is notation. How to read it in English? X does not belong to A. And how to read this? D belong to the set B. 1 belong to the set of natural numbers. 8 does not belong to set of prime numbers. Here, he mentioned that P is a set of prime numbers. Okay. Come to the fourth question. Okay. State whether the following statements are true or false. Justify your answer. Okay. 5 does not belong to set of prime numbers. 5 does not belong to set of prime numbers. Whether this statement is correct? First, you know what is the set of prime numbers? Prime numbers, what is set of prime numbers? Let us denote it by P. 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13. It contains what numbers? The numbers which are not having divisors other than 1 and itself. What is meant by prime number? A number which has no divisors other than 1 and itself. Okay. Now, 3. What are the divisors of 3? 1 and 3. No other divisors. 2. 1 and 2. 5. 1 and 5. No other divisors are there. This is set of prime numbers. Now, what is the question given here? 5 does not belong to set of prime numbers. Because this statement is wrong, I am saying, because 5 is an element of set of prime numbers. Therefore, the statement is wrong. Okay, this is first question in fourth. And come to the second question. Okay. S is equal to 5, 6, 7. 8 belong to S. What is S is given? The set S is given as 5, 6, 7. And what is the statement given? 8 belong to S. Obviously, this is wrong because clearly 8 is not an element of set S. But what he is given? What he is given? 8 belongs to S. Therefore, this statement is false. Okay. Come to the third question. Minus 5 belongs to W. W is the set of whole numbers. Minus 5 belongs to W. Actually, you have tried this capital letters. Capital W. And you know what is W? Set of whole numbers starts from 0. And 0, 1, 2, 3, so on. Now clearly, see here, the negative numbers are not there in the set of whole numbers. But what he is given? Minus 5 belong to set of whole numbers, which is a false statement. This is what here? False statement. Come to the fourth question. And 8 by 11 belong to Z. 8 by 11 belong to Z. Okay. Now, Z stands for what here? Set of integers. Z is also denoted by capital I. Okay, capital I. As all of you know that integers consist of what here? 0, 1, 2, so on. And minus 1, minus 2, so on. Now here, this is a fraction. It is the form of A by B, that is 8 by 11. The fractions are not there in the set of integers. Therefore, here what he is given? 8 by 11 belong to Z, which is a false statement. Okay. We will discuss the roster form and set builder form in the next class. Okay. Because I have to give definitions further. And come to the